talk about trust for a moment and how you develop trust as an organization, as a Covey organization, as one in which that has impact on so many lives around the world. How do you really build trust?
You have to be a trustworthy person. That's a combination of character and competence. For a period of time during our merger, there wasn't that level of trust. We would just kind of announce, today we are merger, we talk about we, our, not me and mine. But little by little we learned the principle of what we teach, and that is you've got to be absolutely trustworthy in order to merit the trust of all of your constituencies.
You certainly must feel this when you're dealing with young people and the teens in the educational system.
Absolutely. I work a lot with schools, elementary and middle and high schools, and we find that the key to increasing, everyone's after increasing test scores, you know, and decreasing discipline problems. And our experience is that the key is the culture, you know, more so than coming in and having new techniques for how to read better or write better and so forth, is getting the culture of the school so that the teachers, you know, getting it strong so that teachers trust each other. There's trust among the staff. And Stephen, in his book, The Speed of Trust, and he calls it speed. You know, when you trust each other, it's amazing how fast you can communicate, how you don't have to double guess each other. And it's all about culture. So we find that, you know, the key to schools is improving the culture, and then inevitably parent satisfaction goes up, teacher satisfaction goes up, test scores go up, discipline problems drop, and so forth.
All good things happen once self-esteem and trust is established.
Yeah, that's why I say trust is the one thing that changes everything. You get good at trust, everything else goes up. It's like a performance multiplier that makes everything else better. It's not a panacea. It's not going to solve every problem, but it will take all your other strengths and make them better through this performance multiplier. Whereas if there's low trust, either in a relationship or on a team, in a culture, in a leader, when there's low trust, you pay a tax on everything. Everything is diminished. It's discounted. It's diluted. It's taxed. And that has negative consequences. So in either direction, trust changes everything. And so I think it's really the foundation of effective leaders and leadership.